In this episode of the Ruth Institute podcast, we tune in again to Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse on Father Rob Jack's radio show, Driving Home the Faith. Dr. Morse discusses many various topics today, including the striking down of the Women's Reproductive Health Act in the Senate, the U.S. trying to force abortions on the Dominican Republic, and the Kissinger-Nixon foreign policy. Dr. Morse highlights the destructive force of the population bomb myth, which, unlike the short-lived success of the Ebola scare, successfully convinced people that there are too many people in the world. Dr. Morse explains that this idea has led to U.S. foreign aid often having strings attached. No U.S. aid if you don't accept LGBT, etc., etc. She points to the Philippines as an example of this subversive maltreatment, who are now being heavily pressured to accept no-fault divorce. Also, the recent happenings in Russia and Ukraine have not escaped Ruth Institute's glance. Russia is below replacement fertility, and they are an aging people. The Ukraine poses a path for solving Russia's population problems. Dr. Morse also discusses the global ruling class and the elites, and asks that we exercise caution when trying to identify them. Find out more by listening to her in her own words.
Well, with us now is Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse, and she heads the Ruth Institute, which is an interfaith nonprofit organization helping defend the family and repair the damage of the sexual revolution. Her most recent book is really a primer on the whole issue, called The Sexual State: How Elite Ideologies Are Destroying Lives. Dr. Morse, happy Lent.
Well, happy Lent to you too, Father. Thanks for having me on the show.
I think you're going to have to hire more staff. There's so much going on with the Ruth Institute. You can have hourly updates, not even just daily ones.
It's very true. It makes me crazy. I thought I was going to have a nervous breakdown this week.
Well, you know, it's a target-rich environment. And
I'm afraid so.
And what's happening is a lot of stuff that's going on, serious stuff, is slipping under the door. You know, because one of the things that almost slipped under the door was that Women's Reproductive Health Act. Thank goodness that went down in the Senate. But, you know, that was one of the things. But the one I didn't know about until actually you reminded me of it in the press release that was put out today about the U.S. trying to force abortions on the Dominican Republic.
Yes, it's everywhere. It has been part of U.S. foreign policy for a long time, really, to promote so-called family planning to poorer countries. And that goes back to, really, the Cold War era. Henry Kissinger and Richard Nixon thought it was a great idea to promote birth control to the poor countries, because birth control would help people to be lifted out of poverty. If they didn't have so many children, they wouldn't be poor. And if they wouldn't be poor, then they wouldn't be likely to become communists. I mean, this was the thought process.
Okay.
And so going back as far as that, this has been part of U.S. foreign policy, has been to promote family planning, which amounts to contraception, and then abortion, you know, almost inevitably follows in its wake. And
also,
isn't Latin America kind of racism
because we're saying that, you know?
From the beginning, it's been about that. You know, I mean, the elites, you know, the title of my book, The Elite Ideologies, we have been told for years that there's a population bomb coming. Well,
yeah.
You know, this is just you could look at that and say, well, this is another instance of fear porn like Ebola or, you know, the swine flu or these various scares that we hit all the time. But the difference between Ebola scaring everybody about a virus and population issue is that people have become utterly convinced that there are too many people in the world. And it's becoming, it's clear to me, look, I can't prove it. I don't know what these guys are really thinking, but I think when they say there are too many people in the world, the global ruling class is basically saying there are more people of the kind we want in the world. These people are not useful to us, so let's have fewer of them. That's their basic idea. And they've been at it for a long time, Father. And, you know, when you start looking around and tracking the particulars, you know, then it becomes really, really clear that this is what's going on. So the thing we sent out this week, it came to my attention because of something that our friends at LifeSite News put
exactly.
out. They did an interview with a bishop in the Dominican Republic, and you know, this poor guy is standing there saying, you know, look, they're trying to impose this on us. You know, they're pressuring people, and they're pressuring people specifically, not just loss of foreign aid, but they're saying, we're not going to give you visas unless you guys do what we want. You know, well, this is the sexual state at work, Father. I mean, this is just, it is using the power of the state to implement the sexual revolutionary ideology. That's what it is. And it's there's no longer any pretense that this is about helping poor people. This is about the rich people in the rich countries saying there are too many poor people, and so you need to do what we tell you, or we're going to push you around. And then when you add to it that they're not just promoting abortion, they're also promoting so-called LGBT rights, you know, which the people in a lot of poor countries are really not interested in that. For a whole variety of reasons, they're really not interested in that. And you can see that this has nothing to do with benevolent foreign aid helping poor people. It has nothing to do with that.
Not when you have all these strings attached to it.
Yep, exactly. And you know, you go back to, you know, you look at the Philippines. They've been hammering away at the Philippines for a long time. That's, you know, it's got to be, God love them. It's like the last Catholic country on earth, practically. We had a guest on our podcast a few months ago, right before Christmas, I think it was, a man in the Philippines who was talking with us about the fact that the elites, with the help of Western aid and international agencies, are trying to promote no-fault divorce in the Philippines. And I'm like, oh my golly, do you have any idea what you're getting into? You know, and of course they don't. They have no idea what this is going to do to them. And there's no support for that in the Philippines. But what they have in the Philippines is you can get divorced for cause and you can't remarry. Okay? And when you look at what divorce does to people and what it does to children, inevitably, it's the multiple remarriages that just rip the guts out of the kids, you know. And when, of course, this is what our Lord, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, second person of the Blessed Trinity, who came to earth to straighten us out, this is exactly what he told us not to do.
You know, Dr. Morse, one of the things that's becoming very obvious to me with all this political stuff, international stuff going on, the winner in all of this is not the United States, and it's not the Soviet Union, Russia. It's Planned Parenthood, because Planned
yep.
Parenthood is using both. Russia has one of the highest amounts of abortion, as we do. And, of course, you know, here you got poor little Ukraine, whichever way they look to, you know, if they look to us, where it's basically, you know, licentiousness, not freedom, and you look to them, it's totalitarianism. It's a no-win situation when the truth is told.
Yeah, and you know, foreign policy is generally not something that I look at too closely. But the one aspect of the Ukrainian situation that we've commented on, and again, not too many other people have noticed this, is that one of the assets that Putin can obtain if he takes over Ukraine is a whole bunch of people. You know, Russia is below replacement fertility. People have been looking at Russia for a while, saying that they're going to have big population problems because their population is aging. They're not getting rich fast enough to deal with all their old people, you know. And so this great thing that was supposed to help everybody by reducing population, it's not working out for them. And so what turns out to happen is they've got this whole infrastructure that has to be maintained and run and so on. Well, they don't have the people to do it. And so taking over more people is a low-cost way for them to solve some of their problems. Now, is this what Vladimir Putin is thinking in his mind? I don't know what he's thinking. But the point is, people are an asset also,
yeah.
Right? And so anyway, that's just I would just put that out there for you.
Well, we see all this craziness going on, and what's clear is I use this image from The Godfather. That's one of my go-to things to talk about the images. And the fact of the matter is, you know, you never know who your real enemy is until it comes out, in terms of the ones pushing this cultural war and pushing not only this elitism, because, you know, the United States is to blame, the Russians are to blame. But and this is my opinion, and you take it, you know, $7 and $8 will get you a latte at Starbucks and not a refill. But, you know, I think the ones pulling the strings right now are China. I think China's pulling it. We got the Uyghur problem. You got the total oppression of people. They got more money than Putin. They're keeping the lines open to Putin, and they're also working on us. You figure, this is how I look at it. And like I said, people can call me a conspiracy nut. I don't mean to be. But, okay, COVID-1 didn't work, COVID-2 didn't work, COVID-3 didn't work. What are we going to do? Let's start a war and see if that's going to upset the apple cart. People of common sense would say, if we have energy resources, then drill, baby, drill. And yet our political leaders aren't doing that. Instead, they're giving the money. I apologize for going this way, but it's driving me nuts. And I got to talk to somebody, and I apologize that it's you.
Yeah,
we are living in a Christless, godless world, and it's about sheer power, and sheer power has the power of life and death. And it's not just the life and death of the unborn, it's the life and death of countries, it's religious freedom. All of these things are tied together. And you say, oh, well, Father, it's a conspiracy. I'm following the data. And you look around, doctor, and you say, this stuff isn't making sense.
The only place where I like to be a little more cautious is I don't really know who's pulling the strings. There's no doubt in my mind that there is such a thing as the global ruling class and that they're up to no good. I just don't know who it really is. You know, it is clear that there are multiple power grabs going on in our world, you know. And, you know, Putin taking over Ukraine is an obvious power grab. But it's, I think, clear to most people now that the whole claim of COVID being a deadly disease that was going to wipe everybody out and the amount of fear that was projected onto everybody, that was a power grab. And a lot of it worked. And a lot of the freedoms that we lost during that period of time, we're going to have to fight to get them back. So, you know, it's a net win for the global ruling class, whatever it is that they are actually up to and whoever they actually are. So that's the only place where I would be cautious with you. And what I would say is that it's clear to me, as somebody who's been involved in the pro-life, pro-family world for a long time, there's no doubt that there is a global ruling class, and they have been manipulating people for a long time, lying to people, distorting the truth, hiding facts, you know, fake science, junk science, the whole nine yards. We in the pro-life movement have been watching this go down for years. It's nothing new to us. Fake science is nothing new to us. And hopefully some people who have kind of had the scales removed from their eyes by looking at COVID and how the public health establishment has conducted itself, we as pro-lifers can say, hey, the public health establishment started lying to you a long time ago. This is nothing new here.
You know, Dr. Morse, does the answer lie in really the second release you talked about today? These people in San Francisco who voted out the school board who was doing a lot of this crazy stuff. I mean, are we getting back to reinforcing subsidiarity? It's going to have to be the local people that's going to bring back, you know, shake the truth out of people and get them back in reality?
Well, I'll tell you, that's a very hopeful sign, isn't it? You know, that parents across the country are fed up. And precisely because of COVID, I guess the ruling class didn't think of this, that if you send all the children home and they have to learn on Zoom, that the parents are going to find out what they're actually doing, you know? And so even in San Francisco, they voted down some of the more radical school board members. Three school board members voted out by 70% margin, right? Parents are waking up, and that's what needs to happen. And I that's the reason I like to come on your show, Father, as I like to tell the people of Cincinnati, hey, you guys, get off your duff and do something. You know, I mean, everybody in every town has the equivalent of this type of stuff. And Americans are good at organizing. Americans are good at standing up for their rights. People in some countries, it's not even a thought in their mind. You know, they could just kind of roll over and play dead. And we don't do that. And yeah. we've lost a lot of that because we've been sitting in front of the TV too long, you know. But which is also part of the global ruling class. You know, they like you being passive. They like you being fat. Think about that. Oh, they yeah. like you being fat. They like you being fat. Think about COVID. They knew from the beginning.
Bread and circuses.
Obesity, Father, obesity is a risk factor for death from COVID. They knew that from the beginning. And you think about the amount of time and energy they spent haranguing people about wearing masks
yeah.
and getting this useless vaccine. If they had had a public service campaign saying, you know, you should lose some weight, you should achieve your ideal weight, you should be outside exercising, they could have done that. They didn't even enter their mind to do that. I conclude they're happy with you being fat and lazy and infirm. They like that.
And ignorant. Don't forget education.
They like that. That's right. That's exactly right. And so what I would say to your listeners, whenever you get mad at the ruling class, you know, and this thought comes into your mind, just think to yourself, I do not want to give them the satisfaction of me being passive in any way. And so if obesity is an issue for you, if passivity is an issue for you, if getting angry and picking fights with people on the internet is a thing for you, don't stop wasting your time. They love that. The global ruling class loves it when we fight with each other, right? Don't do that. Don't give them the satisfaction of becoming what they want you to become, you know? That's what I think. And, of course, we need our Lord and his sacraments and his grace to move forward in any of that. Otherwise, we're going to fall on our faces.
We can't do it without the cross. We simply cannot do it without the cross. As I was saying earlier today, Doctor, the cross is, you know, Christianity, Catholicism stands in the breach. And we are the witnesses. Christ set the bar, and we're not going up to it. And it's time for us to start.
Sounds good to me.
Well, Dr. Morse, thank you for being with us today and, you know, our collective rants. Maybe we learned something. But if people want to find out more about the Ruth Institute as well as your great Dr. J show, where can we send our listeners?
Go to ruthinstitute.org for our main website, or you can find our YouTube channel on YouTube. You just type into the search bar, Ruth Institute, and we pop right up. There's nobody else like us.
Well, thank you very much, Dr. Morse, for being with us today.
Thank you for having me, Father.
You've been listening to the Ruth Institute podcast, where Dr. Morse spoke with Father Rob Jack on the Driving Home the Faith radio show. The Ruth Institute is a global interfaith coalition equipping Christians to defend the family and build a civilization of love. Founded by world-renowned author, speaker, and academic, Dr. Jennifer Roback Morse, the Ruth Institute provides decades of research to support individuals and families harmed by divorce, the hookup culture, and other forms of family breakdown. Our podcast can be found online at ruthinstitute.org/podcasts. If you've enjoyed them, please share them with your friends. Like us on Facebook and subscribe to our weekly newsletter to stay informed.